Saturday morning after the crisp snow. It's now warming up. Clear skies, not a bit of wind. Alright, Kim. How you doing? As you know, if you've seen the tweet today, I will be building the Yolopark Shockwave. Let me go get it. Yes, indeed, O.R. Oh. This box is huge. I can barely fit on my desk. I can't wait to get stuck in. Oh. So, with all this stuff in it, unpacked, and we need to build. A lot of parts just get lots of screws. Built the NZ666 last stream myself, and she's a big last. Very thick. I bet. Nine-hour stream. Damn. That's a long stream. Oh. Someone's at my door. I'll be right back. Oh, hello. I'm back. Sorry about that. IT issues. Yeah, let's change that then. There you go. Changed. Needing help with their laptops. God, some of these pieces, man. A detailing on them, and you won't see half of it. This is already open. How are you feeling then today? I'm a bit tired, didn't get to bed early last night. Busy playing some City Skylines. So many sprues. More sprues in this than there's in any other kit I've built. All right, Jack. I'll snap build it first. And depending, because of how much detail there is in these pieces, I might actually build, you know, do little bits of paint here or there on the way. There's so much detail and it needs to be picked out. So what I'll do is I'll probably build a module, and then before I put the armor on, I'll probably give it like a wash and some highlights. Sure, getting it all out of the packet. So much plastic. Also, there's like some empty sprues. Like, look at all this gap here. What? You know, it's just a bit of a waste. You put other things in there. Maybe reduce the size of the amount of sprues. Jesus Christ. Some decals for Autobots or Decepticons. You can't really see them. There you go. To be fair, once it's built, I might decide to weather it. Weather the armor in that. Transformers aren't all shiny and new, are they? Battle scarred and scuffed. So as nice and shiny as this kit is, oh, working on an MG ball. Plan to paint it in rust color. That's a good idea. I have a ball. They're fun to work with. And painted it. Kept it. Yeah, they're nice kits. They look good in rust. It's an ugly colour. That's the point, rust has always been ugly. But it's fun. I like doing rust. That's a question. Do Transformers rust? Oh, I mean, metallic organism, but they're living metal. Does it rust with oxygen? That's a good question. Alright, that's all the sprues. Ooh, that's a nice color, army green. Yeah, that's a good idea. I do like that idea. I should get some painting done. It's just been too cold to get the airbrush out, which I need to do for a custom build I'm doing. It's going to be lime green in colour, with accents of orange. Right, let's go with this back in the box, and then I can just find out which sprues I need first. Gonna be an avalanche of sprues in a bit if I'm not careful. Just can't believe detailing in this. It's like, Jesus. That needs. This is. They've done this in like a gun metal. And. I think if you give it a nice black wash, so it looks a bit oily, and then just dry brush with the silver. I have the same problem, but I've got an electric heater to get a nice, good temperature. Yeah, I've got a gas heater in my workshop, but I need to get a gas bottle for it. I've got a house used to have this set for gas bottles for the cooker, but I just need to get. I'm going to have to use the digger and get for one of the gas bottles up to the workshop. So I can use my gas heater up in my workshop and then I can actually airbrush. But today's nice and warm. And if tomorrow or this afternoon's warmer, I might do some airbrushing. Maybe have something ready to paint on Monday stream. Does come with his own weapon as well as his left arm. That's cool. That's a chest piece. You can just. That's the front of a chest. It just, that just gives you an idea of the size this is going to be. That's the piping for the weapon on his right left arm. It seems to be a hip joint of sort. Put it there for a sec. There was a shin pad. Shin armor. Just that's a nice. It's like a metallic purple. Unfortunately, like most metallic plastics, it's got the. Like you can see these lines, where the plastic wasn't mixed as well as it could have been. So it's like you can just see them faintly. These lines that go across like that. So this is where the plastic hasn't mixed properly with the metallics in it, and it's left like marks where it goes a little bit darker in the plastic with less metallic in it, and these little wave marks and such. So you can see where the plastic's been pushed in. It's things like that where it's like, oh, it might need a respray, repaint. That's fine, Kim. You go get those jobs. Hunt them down with your spear and pin them to the ground. The Home Office is hiring. All put to one side. Whew. Right. All the sprues are out of the bags, and the bags will go in the bin. Too bad they're not recyclable. But hey ho. Alright, this is a thick ass book. Like, this is an instruction. Look how thick that is. God. Put those almost there. Right. Well, he is a beast. I can't wait to get stuck into this. So many sprue pieces. This is going to be fun. Alright. So I'm going to do the head first by the looks of it. As you can see, look, you go over this detailing on the inside. And then most of it's going to be covered up by armor. So I'll snap build most of the head up to that point. No, I'll actually glue it up to this point. Even with the light in it and all that. And then I probably won't glue that on, I'll probably snap build that on. And then I'll probably paint this, take the armor off, paint the head, and then do weathering on the armor. I think that's the best way of getting around it. So yeah, so let's get the sprues out I need for this. A2, A3, A4. Don't need G's. One side. So there's A's. So I need A1. No, I need A3, A2, and A4. So I don't need A1. That's H3. So I don't need that one. But I do need those ones. I need K1. K3 is over here. Or K4 is over here. I need K3. It's J1. I'm gonna need J1. D1. A2. Nope. K5. Nope. J2. I need J2. J3. It also color codes them so you know what colors you're looking for, which is great.
Why do you need G5? Should I don't think I've come across.
K3. It's K4, so that's all the K's. Don't need any E's. That's G5. We've got here F4. I need F2, F3, F2. One, two, and three. So that's those two. Stay put. I need J3. E5, E2, one of those.
E1.
Nope.
I2.
Yeah.
I think that's it. Just over here, little screws.
So some of the chrome screws have a purple metallic. Most of the time out painting tape on the side and write the letters on it to find the runners faster and easier. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's so many runners.
Runners
I've ever witnessed on a kit.
I've built a lot of kits in my time.
All these runners are taking up space here, so let's put these on the box. So I do have quick access to them. Do I need H1 history? I do. Anyway,
let's start off with K3. Did I find K3? Oh. Me and my hoovers.
Thinking I got them all when I don't. I'm missing one already. Alright, let's find K3. Can you stop? Thanks. Oh, damn it. Let's just make sure I've got it here. K3 is one of the lighter grey ones. So it is like this colour. There it is. Oh, I had it out all the time. Silly me. Yeah, this is just the sprues to start with building the head. And you normally get as many sprues in one Gundam kit. Even
the Unleash doesn't have as many sprues.
Let's get started. Alright, first things first, K7. Now. I thought it was my dog then.
There's a couple of books for me on my leg.
There you go. too tidy because a lot of it's covered up. Right, and you're getting here, you can put LED now straight away. Oh, it's okay, but there's so many little springs I can lose. So the LED unit, which is this one here, and then the batteries for it, which are these little ones here, these itty bitty batteries. Trying to get them out without getting everything else out. To be fair, you can't glue, you can't really glue the head together. In case you need to get to this LED to change the batteries, because these will go after a while and leaking. The last thing you need is battery acid all over your perfectly made model. You use a magnet to turn it on. There's like three different settings. Got that one, and off. Oh, right in my eye. I always blind myself with these things. So that goes in there. Like so. Okay, and then H1. One. No matter if I lose the magnet, I've got tons of magnets. I need 14 and 15, which are these two here. Great thing about this is it's all ABS plastic. So yeah, it's really good, strong plastic. It's not going to be fragile or anything like that. That you get with like a few lot of Gundam kits that some of the plastics are brittle, especially with metallics. On this, it's getting a bit blunt. So it goes in there, like so. That's gonna be a one. So yeah, so probably snap build most of it, glue some of it, and then afterwards I'll probably go over with some wash and some paints. Yeah, so most of the internal parts I'll probably wash with black ink, and then I'll dry brush everything over with a nice silver or something. 17. You think as well, they try and put as many of the same colour stuff and the same sprue that goes to the same place. So you're not having to go back and forth between sprues. Again, it's all about sprue weight and distribution of plastic, the best way to get. So it's not, you don't get like a miscast or something like that. And that. So one that way. So that goes on top like so. Like that. So the LED is completely hidden. But yeah, you cannot glue that together. Together at all, especially if you want to get to those batteries. Depends what I do this afternoon. I might do some painting,
airbrushing,
and get the heater going. Might work on some vintage audio. If I go back over this, I'll definitely stream the process of me doing all this draw washes and that, because I think it would be insightful for others to see, especially a kit like this, you know, washing it and seeing the effects you can get. So far, the kit goes together really nicely. It's really like strong and binding joints. Clear plastics ABS, you can definitely tell when you snip it, because all the Gundam plastic runners you get are so brittle. Painting with rust layer is so strange. Do I have to even be even? Yeah, no, that's the great thing about doing weathering and rusting. Part of the art of it is just you not having to care. Just let, especially with like, a lot of the colours, just let it, you know, just let it pool and bits. And it dries a different colour then, and it shows where most of the water's pulling. It's like a more natural kind of way it works. But doing it, you do have to make sure that when it runs and pulls, you want the piece to be the way you want the gravity to show. So if it's like been sat in dock for a while and pull, and it just pulls down round. So you want it more pulling at the bottom, stuff like that. I do have a kit like that. I'll get it in a second. And then I want H3. Which is this one here? That's K3. Near the top. 13 and 12. These very tiny pieces. Coming from a candy paint. It's an Andrew. Yeah, that is a... When you're doing candy paints, you do have to be quite precise about it. Like my, the custom build I'm doing is a very, it's lime green, but it's almost candy green. So when I'm spraying that, I have to be really careful. What a place to put a damn gate. That one's alright. If you have one, Jesus. So there's a little bit of detail just here. Tiny bit of detail just there. And the gate's right next to it. So you can very easily chop that bit of detail off if you're not careful. That is a bit silly. But I don't want to... such a tiny piece, but I don't want to glue it in. So I want to be able to take the lens out for when I'm painting it. Then I'll probably glue it in after it's painted. There we go. Those little details, even though it's tiny, they do make the lens. The back of his head. 13, that one there. Undergate it in nice areas. So it's really handy. It's Sometimes you can't help but have a gate. Slots in like so. Just slides down there, does it? There we go. So yeah. You can see the swirls in the plastic where it wasn't, plastic wasn't really that well mixed. Yeah, I'll definitely go over all this with a wash. That's not gonna be easy to take off. Box, didn't I? I did. City person. 27. 25, 26, 27. Goes in like so. There we go, look at that. So much detail. This is just the headpiece. I need J3 and J4. So these two here. The idea is I've gone to hairspray chip it up this dry and finish it all off with an oil streak, and that's a good idea. Hairspray chipping. Yeah, that'll definitely look good. Because I do a lot of my stuff by hand. Let me just do this arm a bit and I'll show you. So even the paint chipping I do by hand. I don't do like an airbrush or any of the tricks of the trade like hairspray and that.
So yeah.
Dumb and chipping by. It will be my first time Wall Street. Oh, I see.
So yeah, so this is one of the things I've done with weathering. This is all by hand. As you can see, it's like with a bronze and that, I used like a bluey green, let it sit for recesses. And like all for metal bit, I've gone with like browns and washed it with browns and such. Same with paint chipping, but I used a sponge. So I used a sponge with the paint chips. Gone in there, done like whatever you think the undercoat of the paint job would be, like I would think was black. So I've gone in there with black, then done a load of browns on top to represent the rust. And then I've gone in and painted highlights of silver to show bare metal. Because at the highest point, especially on edges, it'll be bare metal, then with rust around the bare metal. So yeah, that was my last thing I've painted by hand.
I did paint a gas core, but that was commissioned, so I don't have that here.
That's on my Twitter. And at the moment I'm painting, slowly painting this guy for someone's birthday present. So I don't do much airbrushing. Another custom piece I'm doing is going to be base coloured airbrushes, and then after that's all hand painted. Oh, thank you. Years and years of practice. That's a weird gate. I wonder why they didn't that. I don't think this thing will have bare metal. The idea is abandoned for years and years. Yeah, so even the bare metal would still be completely rusted. Especially like with this kit, I'm gonna have to have a look at a lot of pictures. It's from the movie, Bumblebee Movie, this one. Shockwave from Bumblebee Movie. But there's not many, he's not in it for long. He's like part of the prologue, I believe. So it's I'm going to study the pictures carefully and see how weathered he is in those pictures in the movie. See if I want to try and get him up to the same standard. So I'm going to have to go over these chrome bits again with because it's chrome plastic. So when you take the gates off, it's going to be marks. Especially when you're trying to reduce the gates. Luckily I have a silver pen on hand. go over these bits where gates were. Because it's just tiny bits, it's not going to look much different from what for chrome is already. Ooh, smells good. Pen smells good. All tight fits, so you have to put some real pressure on it. And there's his head. But yeah, if you, it's one of those things where with weathering, especially if it's like bow scuffed, just going over edges with a silver pen will make it look a lot different. Especially with golds. People don't realise that. It's like, golds do rub. Especially if you're plated. Having the silver edge to him gives it a little bit of extra detail. Cave.
Son, it's got my slipper. There we go. And then A3. A3.
That's falling off. 20. 20. fit off A3 number 13. Which is right there. A222, which is over here. So it goes on there like so. On there. Cool. And then I need F2, which is this one here, 11 and 15, which are these two. Yeah, I think a lot of people forget when they're painting stuff. It's the story they want to tell. What kind of story do you want to tell with this piece? Because I think that's what a lot of miniature painters forget. Well, especially a lot of new people who are just starting to paint. Because there's a difference between painting something, making it look nice, shiny. But there's also painting it to tell a story. Like you want to make it so your board looks like it's been abandoned for years and years. You have to paint it a certain way to get that. Probably didn't need to put any silver in there, but I thought it might look good. I just did it anyway. This piece is being very uncooperative. There we go. That's it now. Got. Then A4 and A.
A4.
Color is it?
It's a darker plastic.
A4, 22 and 20. These pieces here. So many like moving parts. It's I want A3. Goes on top like that. Oh, there we go. So it's like, so that's just the head done. So it swivels side to side, and it's going to move. Not only does it have a ball joint, so it's going to be able to swivel on that, but the entire neck as well can move, which is pretty cool. There's quite a lot of articulation there. And that's just for head and neck. See ya. That's pretty cool.
cool. Right, I've got your VAs next. So, a 3. Do I need H's? Yeah, I need all the H's. They stay up here. 2. Do I need K? Do I need a K3? Yes, I need K3. K1. D1, two different D1s, two different D5s, right.
D1.
So that's D1, purple. That's D5, purple.
D5 silver.
I want an I2 here. Stay. Looking for D2.
D1 and D5. I think some of the Fs as well. They share two similar sprues. And one's purple, one's chrome. So you can mix and match. So you can make it a little bit more unique. Get those colours differentiation.
So we got F1. There's F6. Don't need F4, so that go back in the box. F3. F1, no here. A1, 2, 3. That's 2 and 4.
Six.
Don't need any of the E's. G6, I need that one. G4? Nope. X7. G1. Nope. Yes. And then it's just G and it's A5. Don't need A5. Don't need A3. Do you leave A3 up here?
No.
I put A3.
It's definitely up here, is it? Oh, yeah, it's right there. See me. And then J1, 2, and
3 and 4. So we've got J3, J2, J4, and just need J1. Okay.
Right, I've got all the sprues I need for the next build, which is a torso.
I think that's half the problem with kids hunting the sprues down.
Right, I need C1. Should be amongst this lot here somewhere.
There it is.
F1.
One and three. There's one. And three. Oh, there it is.
Like that. That's like that. So it goes through there. And then that goes through there like so. Then you need F2. In my desk. 20 and 21. There's 21. And there's 20. C25 as well.
Falling off.
Cool.
Right. So that goes through there, like so. That goes through there, and that goes. goes in like that. And then I need F6. Are undergated, which is nice. And then I need 24. This one here. Not these moving parts, so it's chrome plated plastic, which is a bit weird. So I think some of these moving parts you're not going to see. Goes in like that. Okay. And then it goes in there like so. And this attaches to the other side. Like this. Let's see. There it is. Thank you.
this goes in there first. Like that. And then that goes in there. Like that. So we've got that. Next one is a 21-22, which is good. This is the part that's falling off the sprue. You don't have to worry about it so much now. And then a metal part. So let's get my metal bits, which is like here. Apparently I need metal bit B, which is that one right in the middle. Looks like some of the major joints are metal, which is nice. So yeah, so there's the metal part. I want to get rid of the gates on this first. Take this piece here, then I want to see, so this piece goes in there, like that, then this piece goes on the front, like so, I believe, that's what it showed me. These two join together. Let's get the knife in there, get rid of that. Bit of gate. I forgot. So these pieces aren't going fully together because of the metal piece in between. Interesting. Oh well. We'll have to live with it. As much as I don't like it. Right, next is F222. Take this. And that goes in like that. That goes into. God, so many, that is such a small hole. It's such a small rod. Care if we can easily break that. That goes on there like that, does it? Like so, yeah. Okay. Let's turn the page. There we are. this is definitely not a build for a beginner. I'll tell you that now. Side to that, then it's 19. Okay, and then I want now. Do for now, let's get this together. Off this piece. So that goes on that bit there. In there, placing all of that, those joint parts together. No, that's not gonna work. Come on. There we go. Gotta use my teeth sometimes, just get that pressure on there. It's got fat fingers, so I can't get my fingers in small places to put all the pressure I need on it. So that's got that far so far. This is probably the back, the spine. F3. That's F3. Right, F3, and I need 7 and 6. There we are. 6 and 7.
So
that goes on there, Mr. Gate. So that goes on there, like so. And that goes on the other side, like that. And then, with that in mind, I need G5. I need 4 and 15. These big pieces here. Okay, cool. Take that. I knew I missed one. Okay, that's like it gone. Alright. So, take this. Take this. So, it meant to go like this. Missed a piece somewhere. Don't think I did though. No, it's meant to look like that. Oh, that's weird. A big gap there. Looks like something meant to be in there, but. That did not sound good. But it has freed up everything. Typical. And put it apart and it all comes apart. No, it won't go together properly. No, that side won't go in. This is a weird build, to say the least. Interesting, but right, that's correct how that is built so far. Just don't like there's a gap. Very noticeable gap on all here. Doesn't want to sit in there properly. And like this keeps pushing apart because of the metal joint down here. Alright, let's get G6 done. Hopefully that'll bring it back together better.
articulation in it. Right.
We've gotten that far so far. So we've done the head and the neck.
And we've gotten a good start on the torso. The magnetic switch, which is good. Just on the head alone, the detail on this head is just remarkable. But yeah, if I get some, take the armor back off, do some washes, and then do some highlights, like just dry brush some highlights on. If you do a black wash on this, then do like, because this is a gunmetal colour, and then do like a lighter gunmetal on top, just a dry brush, make it pop a little bit, all these details pop a little bit more. Don't need to be that much of a dry brush. Yeah, his head will sit on top of there, like so. So you can see just from his head and torso, this is going to be a big kit. Articulation. So head's got some great articulation you can be able to do. Quite a lot of poses with this. So yeah. Oops. Let's take this off here for now. The next articulation is good as well. So yeah, definitely. If you can get hold of one, get one. Hard to get them in the UK. Definitely worth it. Alright, I think I'm going to have to call the stream there for today. And I'll continue this on Monday. As well as some painting, I think, of the other kit I'm doing. So, yeah. Hopefully, we'll find out why that's leaving a gap, but yeah. Alrighty, okie dokie. I shall see you Monday night at 8. Well, I will be building more of this. And may hopefully do some painting on the side.